Welcome, folks, to a new Rules Replay cast. This time I got for you a special episode of Rules Replay cast. Well, actually, this game is from Aquila's tournament of a year ago, maybe now. So it's a pretty old one, but at least this game was forbidden to cast for the channel. Gladius, aka Black, said that nope. I don't want to have this cast in public, but the problem is, or my opinion is to this, that it's likely unfair if I cast games where other people lose and I don't cast his games or his loses, so pretty unfair. And this was in tournament replay, which is, well, kind of public because everyone knows how this game or what's the result of this game was. So therefore I'm here to cast it now. Another thing is that Black isn't a member of our channel now because he was a lazy prick. I said to him that he has to produce some videos at his own, and yeah, he didn't thus. So I don't want a parasite, parasite on my channel. That's why I kicked him. But in the meantime, I made some new members of the channel, which are Swiss One Shot and Pain. Those both are producing World of Tanks content mostly, but I think we are gonna play together some games like Company of Heroes 2 and Payday 2 maybe. So pretty interesting, stay tuned what's next on our channel. And yeah, back to the game. We have Bloodiest as American and New York Legal as American too, and they are both playing on the map above the river. Gonna be pretty interesting mirror match here. Let's see how they both start their game. Like starting with 3 depots, 1 barracks. Pretty passive start. He wants to react to what Deagle is playing. So Deagle doing exactly the same, I think, here. Under X, 3 depots and an armor base, which can't be seen as a phantom here. Well, he's also using decryption on Bloody Sector, which is kinda useless, or I don't know why he used this ruse, because he hadn't any camouflage net on his home base. So let's see how this game will Sun is shining into my room here. So going to cap neutral. Looks like Black's trying to harass this side a bit with NGI, cause he sees that there are no defenses on this side for this depot here. Black doesn't want to make the same fatal and yeah, building up in barracks on the right depot here. GI and move. Well, I don't think that is GI. Ah, just Stuart. Okay. Stuart will save the situation if he plays him not near of the forests. Well, yeah, Black already ticked up 2 rangers, and yeah, 1 ranger is enough to defend the supply depot here. In the meantime, Black built up an AT base. Well, playing with armor on this map is, well, not that easy, because I have the problem that There are three choke points which you can easily defend with infantry. So when the armor is driving over the bridge, you can easily push from the out of the forest and encircle him and yeah, fuck the tank with a bazooka. Well, problem here is that those two cities can easily be defended with infantry. So tank pushes without infantry support are here yeah, very senseless. Also this region here, or this sector, is very vulnerable to artillery. So you will maybe see one of them playing priests here. Yeah, GI defending the city now. Pretty sweet spot here, this little forest, because from this one you have a good range on the street here, or even on the bridge. So you can use your forest bonus, and if this GI isn't spotted, you can easily surprise attack the enemy. Well, there it goes. First priest on the way here. Well, black is investing $70 here for the priest. I think there's a second one following. Yeah, the second one is also on the way. So he has to be careful now, because a good push on infantrists could make a lot of damage. But his problem is now that he has to be careful. Yeah, like I said, the region is very vulnerable to the artillery, even with not the high range of a priest. So yeah, I think these buildings are going to get down in some minutes. He's putting up his infantry defense on this side. Well, even for infantrists, it's very hard to overwhelm the enemy or to occupy the other river side, because you are in the open in this region, where the infantrists from your enemy can easily put you down with the bonus of the forest. Oh, nice move here from Deagle. Building up his airfield under camouflage net on this sector here, so it isn't be seen by black until the first planes take off now. It's also targeting this depot here, which isn't protected by any anti-air or the Willy. Pull back the Willy. We need it. Well. Camouflage net was kind of senseless here, because Willy, Cheeky Willy here, was scouting the depot. Yeah, that's why it was a pretty good move from him here. I don't know if Bloodies has awaited this or seen a truck moving, moving this side here. But now Bloodies is also committing himself on air. He primarily, well, built up the AA base, but problem is with the AA that he has to cover a lot with AA to protect all circles and everything from his base. Yeah. So the better thing is to play air himself. Problem is that he both lost one depot now, but I think Deagle's losing the grasshopper. Sub grasshopper, does it go down in time? Well, got one warhawk, lost the grasshopper. Well, all in all, this was, I think, a good trade. Because a grasshopper or a warhawk, well, economically they are both worth the same, but in an air fight, a grasshopper can do a lot less than a warhawk. So, problem is now for Deagle that he hasn't got that much money on the field, or that high economy to be more aggressive. Has to be careful with his bombers, so he didn't commit that much in airfield. They are both securing the mid, Well, there are two types of playstyles on this map here. One thing is a big battle in the mid here, or, well, maybe third. I also see people playing on this side here, moving some bases around here and then trying to attack over the fields here, which is pretty good if you play with tanks, because they are out in the open, they got, or they are more maneuverable than in the forest here, or in the in this tiny area. Second thing is to play with air, which both of they do, because they know, well, sacrificing my units in the forest here is kind of senseless. So because this is a big map, I can play a lot with air and really comfortable, so this kind of second or third playstyle. First, playing on this side, or making a front on this side and defending this side for a big battle on the mid, or playing air. Well, but both of them aren't committing that much. They are not really aggressive until Neil put up his Air Force. 1M16 is supporting now Black's 5 P40s. How much does Neil have? 5-6 Warhawks. Ooh, one more. So pretty good, and also some fakes on the way. Well, that can be very, or this can end very bad for one of them, at least. So he's retreating now. His Air Force, the one Warhawk, get almost. He's using fanatism. Same thing that Black does. Let's look at the points. Bloodius, Eagle. Well, I think 1-3. Yeah, I think he lost 3 Warhawks. Black lost 3 Warhawks, and Eagle had around 6, and he lost, well, 0. But I think he lost 1 and produced 4. So all in all, he got a better air, better move. So for him, Uli got destroyed. Pretty cheeky move, which Eagle was planning here. He tried to sneak around his Uli, around the base, and then scout the airfield, so he didn't have to use a grasshopper. I think I go to double speed, because there's not happening much until because they don't want to. Both of the players don't want to commit himself in an air fight. He could maybe use one more. One more M16 or some kind of more AA. Because he has to protect also this side from the air, and also maybe this side, because he can easily fly around with bombers and then attack in this direction. Which he is doing now, I think. Or maybe not. Maybe just tries to intercept the truck here, and gets intercepted himself by 2 Warhawks, and boom goes the dynamite. Or at least the burns in the woods, like, no cigarette. What Gladius is in the lead of points at 2071. I think he destroyed it. He destroyed the depot here. Okay. So Deagle is now up to $18 remaining in his last depot, while Black is up to $18.27. You can easily, you can easily put up his third depot, I think. Yeah, third depot now on the way, camouflaged, but I think it can easily be destroyed by 2 bombers again. Does he get a grasshopper? Yes, he has. I got 2 bombers, I think. Enough. Ooh. depot was empty until before his bombers could drop their bombs. But well, at least he got the artillery in the A base. One bomber was destroyed in the fight after that. Well, $10 efficiency was $10 for a deagle. 116, 216, 180 gun. He's pulling back himself from the mid region because, well, he actually don't need to defend this the mid that hard. He can easily reproduce his units, and I think the depot goes down. I think because it was on a camouflage, but the M6 was placed up too near to the depot, so the bomber targeted the M16 and the bomb splash damage destroyed the depot here. Bad move, bad placement of the unit, bad location or whatever of the unit here. I think he's now trying to make a final push or something like that to attack the airfields here. He had two priests, the ranger, the AT gun, some A guns, well, and no economy here. They're both acquiring, I think, $1 every four seconds. But that's not a mass of splitting his infantry very well. So he lost one bomber for three infantrists. That didn't pay off at all. But he has to be careful now, because there's not that much ground supply to hold off the infantry here and this turret. Well, Black surrendered because I think he couldn't win the fights though. Problem was for him that at the end he haven't got that big afros like Deagle has or had. So if you've seen the income, the third depot, well, it paid off and Ladius had an advantage of $120 in the game. But yeah, he lost the air fight, which is pretty amazing because he's actually a very good air player. Well, I think he made some faults like placing the AA near to the depot, and that was actually the only fault he did. Otherwise, he could rely on his third depot and old macro Deagle. Deagle played very well, used his option he had to harass Bloodius. And well, it was actually both of them played very passive, don't want to commit himself that much. So, but all in all, that's also interesting, especially on this map. And yeah, was kind of pro game, I would say. So I hope you enjoyed too, and yeah, thanks for watching and see you next time.